I think that when it comes to a job, there is a totally counterintuitive way to approach it. I routinely show people how to negotiate $10,000, $25,000 raises all the time. And you're like, that's crazy, there's no way, et cetera, et cetera, excuse, excuse. Here's the different approach. The first way that most people think is like, if I'm gonna negotiate for a raise, which like, oh, they might just like fire me, that's problem number one. That's the wrong way to look at it. If you go in and ask for a raise, you're not devaluing yourself, you're actually increasing your value. Because what type of person would go in and ask for a raise? A top performer. So the second thing is, they believe that they have to kick down the door of their boss and say like, give me money. Well, if you do that, of course they're gonna kick you out. That's a very impolite way to do it. A third way is much more effective. So I'll just give you like the quick lay of the land. If you wanna get a raise, for anybody watching, this is how you do it. You send an email to your boss, you say, you know what? I would love to meet with you and I would love to discuss what it takes to be an absolute top performer in this role, to make your life easier. Could we set up some time in the next week or two? Of course, 100% of bosses are gonna say, yes, I'd love to see you. So you go in there and you say, hey boss, really appreciate you taking the time. I've enjoyed my role. I just wanna tell you that I don't wanna just do a fine job. I wanna be a top performer here. And I would love to know exactly what it takes for me to be a top performer. Okay, so let me just pause right here. If I'm the employee and you're the boss, how do you feel right now with me walking in and asking this?
So fucking good.
Because we're creating value, right? And I'm not coming in saying like, give me money. I'm like, please advise me. You're the boss, I wanna learn from you. So the boss is gonna say, they're gonna give you some generic answer because they weren't prepared for this. Oh, you need to show up and blah, 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 whatever. You say, I really appreciate that. I'd love to get really specific. In fact, I did a little bit of research before I came in. Here are three things I think would make. Look at the face! Because bosses don't hear this. Most of their employees just show up, do what's expected, and then they're like, how come I'm not getting a $10,000 raise like Ramit said? Because you don't deserve $10,000 unless you go above and beyond. So, you know, hey boss, I know that I'm currently working on this sales project and we're slated to have a 3% improvement. I really think we can do 6. Would that be part of top performing role here? Yes. What about this? Da da da. So you have a little discussion and you say, okay, am I reading this right? These three things would help me really outperform at this role. Yes. Okay, I'll tell you what. I'd like to get to work on this. I'm gonna commit to sending you an update every week or every 2 weeks. And at the end of 6 months, I'd like to come back and show you what I accomplished. If I do it, I'd like to discuss a salary adjustment at that time, but let's not even worry about that right now. Let's have me focus on this. What do you say?
Fuck yeah. Yeah.
Okay, right?
1,000%.
So this is the first conversation. Now I go back to my desk, I send a written record. Every Friday, I'm sending an update. Here's where we are, blah, blah, blah. Now the time comes 6 months from now. And by the way, this is true for negotiating a raise. It's true for dating and relationships. It's true for entrepreneurship. All the work is done before you ever set foot in the room. Ironically, everyone fixates on going in the room. What are the fancy words? It's like, yeah, I'll show you the words, but all the work is done before. That's what every successful person knows. So I send another email now and I say, you know what? As you know, I've been updating you every week for the last 4.5 months. I have some fantastic results. You know, we hit this, we hit that. I'd love to come in and present the whole thing to you. Can we set up some time? Yes. So now I go in. By the way, I've done my homework and I've done it in a couple of ways that nobody else does. Number one, I've researched my compensation. So let's say I'm being paid 50K, but I researched my salary on salary.com pay scale and I discovered, you know, my range should actually be 56 to 62. Okay, good, I'm writing that down. Second, I have a couple of my coworkers and I go to them and I say, hey, you know, we've worked together on this project. I would really appreciate it if you would send an email to the boss and just say, you know what? Ramit's been doing an incredible job. He really helped drive this process through and get us that 6.2% conversion increase. So now I walk in, you've got those emails. You're like, this is the greatest employee on earth. I walk in, I say, you know what? I'm so proud. We accomplished this, we accomplished that. We discussed this 6 months ago. I wanted to be a top performer. Here you go. You theatrically pull out your results out of your briefcase. It matters to be theatric, right? And then how's the boss feeling right now?
Amazing.
Amazing. Everybody's happy, you winning, you're doing your boss's job for them, they're happy. And then you say, you know, there's one last thing. I know we discussed having a discussion about a compensation adjustment. I'd like to talk about that right now. Now you get to have the conversation. You've got all your data, you've already made the boss a ton of money, and all the words you can use are right there in the book and on my courses. That's how you negotiate your salary. So when people say like, oh, there's no way I can negotiate. Yeah, there's no way if you just walk in and say, give me money. But if you actually become a top performer, then it makes perfect sense that you would get top performer compensation. Mm-hmm.